Lower productivity in business is one major factor holding back developing economy growth. To give an example, based on data from 2005, sales per employee in a U.S. firm are over $430,000. Sales per employee in a firm in the Philippines, shown in this picture, that's about $102,000. In Indonesia, it's $80,000 per employee. In China, it's actually only $66,000, though of course it's gone up since 2005. The firms in the other countries simply aren't as effective in producing things. Why might that be the case? This is a difficult topic to get a grip on. Nonetheless, we do know of several factors. First, in less productive economies, typically lower managers have less autonomy. This is because they are trusted less, and this makes it harder for them to implement productivity improvements. So at the same time, these firms have too much disorder, but they also have too many bureaucratic rules. In general, there's less delegation of authority. There are also weaker promotion incentives in a lot of firms in developing nations. Some of this comes from nepotism, namely that family members or friends are in some ways favored or trusted more. Tying back into that trust issue, there's also a greater fear of managerial theft in a lot of firms in developing nations. There are two other factors which hold back productivity in these firms. The first is that finance may be a constraint, especially for smaller firms. This again ties back to the trust issue. And finally, infrastructure is not always as well developed. For instance, if electricity and water supply are subject to question, this will make the firm less reliable and less productive. In general, firms become more productive when they can grow in size and also when they can decentralize, which gives lower and middle managers the ability and the incentive to implement improvements in productivity, especially when those individuals operating in a decentralized capacity see a lot of local and specific ways of doing things better, which they would like to implement, but without having every time to get explicit approval from the higher powers in the firm. So what predicts the ability to decentralize a firm if we look at evidence across many different nations? Well, one study showed that there were a few key factors. These included trust, the presence of rule of law in the country, and having a non-hierarchical religion. By the way, if you're wondering, the hierarchical religions were, in this study, classified as Catholicism, Islam, and Eastern Orthodox. And finally, having product market competition in the country correlated with higher productivity in the firms. Those variables were associated with greater firm decentralization as well. This is a topic which economists are only beginning to research with any degree of accuracy, yet its importance is well understood. For further reading, I would recommend Googling to these two articles.